Mr. Monti, when you look at Brexit, is there anything that the UK can and should do now to actually break the impasse?
It must break the impasse, and I think it is also in the interest of the EU to do so. What I think confuses the ideas of the British public opinion is probably that what is out there under all the attention is the amount to be paid. I understand that today the government may authorize the Prime Minister to substantially increase that amount, perhaps double it. Well, this may give the public opinion the impression that it is a market negotiation, a souk dealing about the amount of a penalty that has been inflicted to the UK for having decided to go its own way. This is absolutely not the case. This is not a fine on the UK. This is just what happens when there is the liquidation of any company. The different shareholders take on assets and liabilities. So it would have been much preferable if these sums had come out of a fine calculation, yep, which is going on, about how much objectively the UK has to pay. Then there are the other negotiations, of course, on many other aspects. But it's a pity, I believe. I mean, if I were a Brit, I would
emotion,
be a bit offended that,
yeah,
there is a price out there for
for how to get. I mean, I guess it's emotions and the,
yes,
referendum, and that's
emotion,
kind of what you see. We heard from
but
the Brexit
Secretary. I think good politics is to dominate emotions, basically.
In an ideal world. Brexit Secretary David Davis says there's a 50-50 chance that there will be an agreement at the December summit. Do you think it's higher or lower?
He is well informed, certainly better than me. I believe that there might be a 50-50 probability.